As the country's largest education authority, catering for a quarter of a million pupils, Ilya now has to make some stark choices about their future. Drastic cuts are needed for the first time since 1979 to balance the books. If they're not made, a confrontation with the government's inevitable. Ilya blamed Kenneth Baker for forcing them into a corner. The education secretary made no secret of his dislike of Ilya's leader, Francis Morel, at last year's Tory party conference, but reports that he's planning to use Ilya's financial crisis to discredit Labour in the general election campaign were, he said, speculation masquerading as fact. Francis Morel, though, sees things differently.
Given his long-standing, really very personal animosity to the authority, it does seem as if he is deliberately trying to destabilise the authority by wrecking its budget.
So why should you not now be tightening your belt like everybody else has had to in past years?
For a very simple reason. What the government is requiring education authorities to do is wrong. That's the reason. It is wrong for the government to require that less money is spent every year on the education of each child. That is wrong.
But while the political posturing continues, the youngsters in London's classrooms face an uncertain future, but a future which the Tory opposition on Ilya believes should have been sorted out long ago.
There are a lot of savings that can be made. Unfortunately, at this late moment in time, due to the way the Labour Party has delayed now for many, many months, I suspect that savings, if made, some of them may well hurt the provision of the service.
Meanwhile, there's one lesson the government intends everyone to learn in the new local government bill, which will stop education authorities arguing about the funds they can raise. Meanwhile, Ilya has just 5 weeks to decide the politically sensitive issue of where to make cuts or face the politically explosive issue of backing an illegal budget. Marcus Powell, Thames News.